Christmas. Welcome to the Blount Family Christmas Lights, right here in the area of Nellie in Laguna Hills, California. So here's the outside of our home with over 100,000 lights on it. They're all timed to music. We run 13 different songs. Each night, folks come by the house to watch the lights, get some fresh donuts, a little bit of apple cider, and then we also conduct home tours throughout the season, too. You're able to come inside and see just what it looks like. I'm Andrew Blount. I'm 39 years old, living in Laguna Hills, California.
Michelle Blount and Faith Blount. I'm a jelly bear.
Oppan Gangnam Style.
Welcome to the Blount family home.
Yay! Give me five. Job well done. Yay! Good job. Come on in. So the first thing you see when you come into our home is an absolutely gigantic upside down Christmas tree. Now the darndest thing about this tree, everybody asks if it's a real tree or not. And I tell you what, this tree is a Siberian fir. And so in Siberia, trees grow this way. So you know, like a deciduous tree is usually larger on the top than it is on the bottom. That's the way these trees grow in Siberia. And so we have one brought over from Siberia each year, and we hang it just right here. When the kids see it, they absolutely love it, because first thing they say is, wow, you get a lot of presents underneath that tree. So if you come over this direction, what do we have?
This is our Department 56 original snow village. I've been collecting this village since 1994, and it's grown a little bit over the years. And I basically hand carve all the styrofoam and all the different levels in order to kind of make the little houses look like a village. And this room you're gonna find Disney, also Department 56. We've got a stage on top of a grand piano, including Mickey ears and all the different levels and some moving pieces too with Mickey Mouse. Over here we have a boardwalk, including roller coaster, the little roller coasters that go down, Ferris wheels, teacups, and a carousel. our ice palace. We'll find our North Pole Village. This is my North Pole Village, including a train that goes around the track and through a treadle and around the other side. It is my largest collection that I currently have, and it's probably the most time-consuming one that it takes for me to put up. About a month and a half to 2 months to actually get it, all the different little houses set up on the table, including carving of the styrofoam and getting the train up and running.
And the lights!
Don't forget the lights!
And the twinkly lights!
Don't forget the lights! And the table! Don't forget the table!
And the Christmas tree on the table!
The giant Christmas tree on the table.
Here is the Grinch's Cookville. It's very whimsical, it's kind of fun, and the challenge for all the kids when they come in and adults alike is to find all the Grinches on the table. I believe we're up to 12 Grinches now, and so the kids actually have a really good time trying to count all the different Grinches that have been included on the table, including the ornaments.
Come on into our living room. So in here is the main tree of our home. We have Santa Claus coming down the chimney. Welcome to our home. So this all started back in 2008 when Michelle was in charge of Christmas. And she would decorate the inside of the home and she'd decorate the outside of her home. We lived in a different home at the time. And it'd all be something that was really beautiful. And outside she'd have these big giant snow globes with things flying around in them and all kinds of incandescent lights and stuff that blinked and all those type of things. And she comes running into the house one night. You see, she was in charge of Christmas, and as a good husband, what that meant is it was my job to complain about the number of boxes of Christmas stuff that were out in the garage. And I was a really good husband because what I do?
Complained about the amount of Christmas stuff out in the garage.
A lot. So she comes running into the house in a total panic one night, about a week before Christmas, and she's really concerned because she's outside, there's people walking around, and she can't get the lights back on. And so I ask her,
have I checked the breakers? And of course, I know how to check breakers, so I'm like, yes, dummy, I've already checked the breakers.
So I go out to the front of the house, and on the inside of our house, where stuff isn't even plugged in, the electrical outlets are charred. We are talking melted beyond recognition. There's no way you're ever gonna plug anything into these lights and your light sockets again. And so I look at her and I tell her,
not only are you not getting the lights on tonight, but they're never coming on, because you've charred an entire panel of lights. And at that very moment, I was like, gonna cry or divorce him? Maybe both. But I looked at him and said, yeah, but you're gonna get the lights back on, right?
So I go and I run some extension cords from the back of the house. I plug in some LEDs that I picked up at the store, and I put up a little light display outside, and it was a lot of fun. People came by and really enjoyed it. We moved to this home in March of 2009, and it had been a tough year for a lot of folks the preceding 12 months. And we figured that, you know, we could put some lights up outside, maybe make a little show out of it, folks might enjoy it. It might put a smile on their face, and it'd be something that was fun and free to do right here in Orange County. And quite frankly, there's not a lot of free things to do in Orange County. So we put the lights up, people started coming by, and then early December we had a Christmas party. And so Michelle had decorated the inside of the home fabulously for the Christmas party. And a couple days after the party, her mom, Evelyn, says, "Hey Andrew, let's go outside and let's watch the lights tonight." So I said, "No problem, let's pick up some apple cider at the store so we'll have something to drink while we're watching them." So we get some cider, we head outside, her and I are sitting outside watching the lights, and lo and behold, people start stopping and standing right next to us. And I start looking around saying, well, everybody should have apple cider. And so I go inside and I make some more cider. I come back outside and there's Michelle's mom trying to tell this family about what a great job Michelle's done on the inside of the house.
So she's explaining to this family that I have this amazing upside down Christmas tree, and that I've got this great snow village that we've built with this hot wire foam tool, and we've carved it all, and they're trying to understand this whole concept of the snow village and the upside down tree. And after them just not getting it, she finally says, "I'm gonna bring you in the house." So she sneaks an entire family into the house. And after the first family comes through, the next time it's like two families, and then it's four families. And before you know it, it's a couple days, and there's like droves of people following her in the house.
Well, last year we toured about 70,000 people through our house, and we passed out over 1,800 gallons of apple cider, and it's really stuck. People come by from far and wide to enjoy the Christmas lights. We have folks that came over from Phoenix, they come down from San Bernardino or Santa Barbara, Pasadena, all the way here just to see our lights and hopefully have a smile on their face with a little bit of Christmas cheer. So thanks for watching. Hopefully you'll come by and you can enjoy the Blount Family Christmas Lights. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody. $4.